I am with Saira Shah Halim, CPM candidate from the Kolkata South Lok Sabha constituency. Saira ran a spirited campaign but lost to TMC's Mala Roy. We will talk to Saira about what went wrong with her campaign and also with the left in Bengal. Saira, hello and welcome to The Print.
Hi Deep, thank you so much for having me over, and wish all the viewers of Print a fantastic day ahead. Yeah.
So Saira, before we come to you,
yeah,
let us begin with what has been going wrong with the left in Bengal. 2019 Lok Sabha polls, zero seats. 2021 assembly polls, zero seats. And 2024 Lok Sabha polls, again zero seats. What's going on?
So let's just make it very clear at the outset. If you see that CPM has had its good days, if you look at the, you know, the innings, like from 1977 till 2011 has been a fantastic
34
run.
Long years.
Yeah, 34 long years, which has been unprecedented anywhere in the history of India. Now, Mamata Banerjee, if you see, she's been a fiery opposition leader. If you look at the whole Singur agitation, Rizwanur's, murder case, she came in the limelight during the Singur agitation.
Singur Nandigram.
Nandigram, Singur agitation. So now it's very easy to blame the left for everything. I'm just like, in very short, I'm just putting the perspective right. So people say that left was a very anti-industry, and that is how it gave leeway to Mamata Banerjee. So I just want to make one thing clear, that if you look at the period from 2006 to 2011, when Buddha Dev Bhattacharya actually brought in IT industry. I myself been a part of the IT industry for many, many years. I've worked with Wipro Sector 5 as a communications trainer. I've been with the IT industry for many, many years. He did try to bridge the gap between the rural Bengal and the urban Bengal. If you look at the malls, the flyovers, the industries, all came during Buddha Dev Bhattacharya's time. And what happened is that there was an anti-incumbency. Any political party that's been in power for far too long, people say, "E bare ek to change dekhte chahe." You know, people say, "We want to see a change this time." And Mamata, you know, put up these brilliant slogans that if not now, then never. Poriborton, you know, change, change, change. So I think people said that we've been giving left a chance for the last 30, 35 years. Let's give this woman a chance and see what she can do. So that is how an importance, you know, see it like even Jadavpur was, you know, we kind of lost in 2011 when Buddha Dev Bhattacharya lost from his constituency. So from then on, it's been a gradual decline. I agree. But if you look at the civic elections, if you look at panchayat election, if you look at my run in the assembly bipole in 2022, the left just felt rejuvenated because suddenly a candidate had got a 30% vote share. You know, what it was in 2021, it was a 5%, and I managed to increase it to more than 30% within a span of 1 year.
I'm talking about the 2022
bipole, assembly bipole from Baliganj, yes, where I stood against Babul Supriyo. So I I was known as somebody who brought in that left resurgence, you know, within a year. And that is the reason the party nominated my name for the Kolkata South candidature, for Kolkata South. Now, that was one constituency. This is seven constituencies. So, like I said, it's about anti-incumbency. The BJP has been making inroads into West Bengal for a very long time. If you look at the various RSS shakhas that have come in. Who is giving the no objection certificate? It is Mamata Banerjee. During the left's regime, there was not a single RSS shakha in West Bengal. There was not a single BJP seat. So this whole theatrics of, you know, being someone who is anti-BJP is not factually correct. Because everybody knows that she's been working in tandem with the BJP. She has invited the fascist forces. Because if you see the last years, since 2011, since she has come in, there's been a competitive communalism. That, okay, Ram Navami has been celebrated, you know, in kind of, in peaceful manner in certain areas of India. But if you look at the Hindi heartland, sometimes these incidents go a little, you know, over the line, they become violent. So she says, I'm going to do a bigger fest. And she has encouraged these lumpens to spread violence in certain minority pockets because of festivals. Kolkata, for one, has celebrated Diwali, Durga Puja, Kali Puja, Christmas, New Year's and everything. And suddenly we are seeing this whole, you know, the climate of fear, which, you know, which was never there in West Bengal. We've seen the rise of right-wing forces. You put up a post on social media and you'll get to see suddenly there are these very vitriolic comments. And West Bengal was never like this. It was never pro-right, at least from what I know in the last 30, 35 years. But we've seen a decline of liberal values. We've seen a decline of progressive values where, you know, religiosity is more, you know, pronounced out in the, you know, open domain. And look at our campaigns. They've become very communal. BJP ir harano jonno TMC ke vote dite hobe. Now, if you want to defeat BJP, you need to vote for the TMC. So because of the bipolar binary that was created, fresh educated candidates, young candidates, like so many other people, whether it's Dipshita, whether it is, you know, anybody like from Jadavpur, people like Shrijan, me, a lot of people could not win because of this binary that no, we need to defeat the BJP, so you need to vote for us. We are the only party that can defeat the BJP. I'm sorry. The left is the only party, I would say, that ideologically can defeat the fascist forces, because TMC per se does not have any political ideology. It is an opportunistic party. It has campaigned, you know, what do you call, very, very divisively in the previous elections, you know, and it has encouraged BJP. Why? Because why would you give tickets to previous BJP ministers? Don't you have your, you know, foot soldiers from the TMC? Don't you have sound leaders from the TMC that you can give tickets to? Why pivotal seats? You know, all pivotal seats have been given to previous BJP runaways, if you look at it. So I really do not believe in this narrative that Mamata Banerjee is a very secular leader or she is going to fight the BJP. You don't fight BJP like that. Electorally, yes, she's had a good kind of a win this year, you know. But overall, I'm seeing the whole picture is a little hazy as far as West Bengal is concerned. A larger part, India, yes, we needed a stronger democracy, I agree. And I appreciate Rahul Gandhi's hard work, Congress's hard work, that we could manage to at least, you know, rise up to the occasion and say, yeah, we are going to fight the, you know, the fascist forces.
You know, it's often said about Mamata Banerjee that she's left of left. You know, her her policies, Lakshmi Bhandar, Konyashri, they're very pro-left policies. So, would it be correct in saying that the left does not have a political space in Bengal anymore, beyond the issue of political, beyond the issue of communal binary that you spoke about?
See, I will not say that these policies are wrong. We would say if the left was in power, we would have given more money than, you know, what she's been giving in Lakhi Bhandar or somewhere. These are good policies. What I'm trying to say is that it shouldn't only be a matter of, you know, 1,000 rupees that we're giving you this social security for 1,000 rupees. We need to look at education. If you look at, you know, the various scams that has riddled West Bengal for many years, look at the education scam. Unprecedented. 26,000 people have lost their jobs. The education minister is sitting in jail. He's rotting in jail. But the binary was such that nobody really cared about the Russian scam or the coal scam or, you know, the education scam. People wanted to boot out the BJP and they did that. And I feel somewhere down the line, the social welfare schemes like the Lakhi Bhandar and everything, it did work. Women did vote for Mamata Banerjee en masse. That I agree. So I think left will need to relook at how you can create space with the masses, you know, because it might have won the trust of the middle class voters, of the educated people, of the elites, but we also need to regroup and think of a way how we can connect to the masses, because Mamata Banerjee, like you said, has these social schemes going and it's very difficult to compete against these schemes and say, no, this is not good. We are not going to say that it's not good. It is good because there is a certain section strata of society that needs those schemes. Mm. Because West Bengal has also been riddled in poverty for many, many years. So, these schemes work. What the left is trying to do is, we are trying to look beyond the, you know, the social welfare schemes and say, let us get our children back to the schools. Because last so many years, 8,000 schools, more than 8,000 schools have been shut. Mm. If you look at the percentage of the students that have been giving Madhyamik exams, that has decreased. So, yeah.
So, Saira, there has been a generational shift in the left, you know, in a manner of speaking. There's you, of course, there's Srijan, there's Deepshita. But even this gamble didn't work. So, what will work now?
Actually, this gamble is working. For example, in 2 years ago, I increased the left vote share from 5% to more than 30% within a year. This time, people voted for something else. This time, people just felt that the left right now is not competent enough, you know, to defeat the BJP, and let us vote for a party that is in a stronger position to vote to defeat the BJP. So that is what has happened. It's not that Srijan is not competent. It's not that I'm not competent enough, or Meenakshi Mukherjee is not competent enough, or anybody else is not competent enough. We are educated. We do not have criminal cases. We are much younger than the, you know, the other candidates, and we are raring to go. It's just that the electorate needs to give fresh, educated, hard-working candidates a chance, and really need to have faith that we are strong enough where we can amplify your voice in the parliament. We do not have criminal, we don't come from criminal, you know, backgrounds. We are not interested in minting money because, you know, touch wood, we all are okay, we all are educated. They are like, what do you call, full-time party leaders also who are willing to put in that extra mile.
So, what are your plans for the 2026 assembly polls in Bengal? Are you going to contest A, and what do you think are the prospects of CPM, realistically speaking?
It's too premature to talk about that. I didn't plan to contest for this year's election. I didn't plan to contest. I was not vying to contest in 2022 by-election either. I was not even a member when I stood for the elections like 2 years ago, contrary to what people might think. I've been a liberal progressive voice. The party nominated my name and persuaded me to stand. It took some persuasion, and I stood for the election, and I gave a very good fight to Babul Surbhi. He still trolls me, by the way, on Twitter. So, it's 2 years ahead. Now that I'm in it, I am putting in my 100%. I gave in more than 200% in this, you know, Lok Sabha election. It is unfortunate that some excellent candidates could not make it. Because of the TMC-BJP binary, a lot happens in politics. You don't know what will happen 1 year down the line. There might be a by-election. You don't know what might happen 2 years down the line. So, I will not say anything right now that whether I will stand or I will not stand. But I'll definitely work towards making India a more robust, healthy democracy in whatever platform I get, be it in the national media, be it in the literary space, be it if I'm writing a book, or be it any other podium, and if I have to fight elections for that, I'm open to it.
So, what do you think about the results of this year?
I think it was encouraging, if you look at Pan-India, because at least now we have legs to stand upon. I just felt that the way Mr. Modi and the BJP were going about passing this draconian laws without check and balances, it has been unprecedented. Three CMs getting arrested, journalists being attacked, houses of journalists being raided, civil activists being arrested. I mean, come on. Omar Khalid is still in jail. Sanjeev Bhatt is still in jail. The people who have, you know, dissented and critiqued the government, for that they're rotting in jail. And it makes me immensely that they're brilliant, educated people who have been really upright, and they've been given the tag of a criminal. They've been very draconian charges, you know, which needs to be challenged at this juncture, because it's not good for democracy. Just because you're dissenting the government does not make you an anti-national, does not make you an enemy of the state. So the government was using various arms, of governance to see that important dissenters, critics get silent, which is unfortunate. Now, at least, like I said, we have legs to stand upon. We have a good number of opposition leaders in the parliament, and I'm sure they're going to give Mr. Modi a very rough time, the BJP a rough time. So it's a good time to be an Indian in a healthy democracy. So overall, I'm pretty happy with the result on a pan-India basis there.
So just before the polls, in an interview, you had said that you'd want to see Rahul Gandhi as the Prime Minister of India. Did that go down well with your party, A, and do you still stand by it?
See, I still believe Rahul Gandhi, I think his time has come. Before he becomes grayer, I want to see him as the PM. I was a huge admirer of Rajiv Gandhi, being an army kid, and I, you know, literally howled my eyes out when he died. I was a kid when I was reading the newspaper, and that's the time when I just kind of just started reading the newspaper. I was very young, what, class 4th or 5th, I don't recall, but very young. And then when his death shook me up. And I feel a sense of resonance in him that he's an honest guy. He wants to make a change, and I think his time will come. He definitely deserves to be the PM. It's nothing about the party. It was an individual tweet and an individual opinion. I'm sure the party doesn't mind.
Okay. Thank you, Saira. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.